देश श्री ईएसएल नरसिम्हन चीफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ आंध्र प्रदेश श्री एन चंद्रबाबू नायडू यूनियन मिनिस्टर्स ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी एंड अर्थ साइंस डॉक्टर हर्षवर्धन साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी एंड अर्थ साइंसेज श्री वाईएस चौधरी जनरल प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द इंडियन साइंस कांग्रेस एसोसिएशन प्रोफेसर डी नारायण राव वाइस चांसलर ऑफ श्री वेंकटेश्वर यूनिवर्सिटी प्रोफेसर ए दामोदरन डिस्टिंग्विश्ड डेलीगेट्स लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन आई एम डिलाइटेड टू बीइंग द न्यू ईयर विद डिस्टिंग्विश्ड साइंटिस्ट फ्रॉम होम एंड अब्रॉड इन द होली सिटी ऑफ तिरुपति आई एम हैप्पी टू इनॉग्रेट दिस 104th सेशन ऑफ द इंडियन साइंस कांग्रेस इन द पैनोरमिक कैंपस ऑफ दिस वेंकटेश्वरा यूनिवर्सिटी एंड आई अप्रिशिएट द इंडियन साइंस कांग्रेस एसोसिएशन फॉर चूजिंग एन एप्रोप्रिएट थीम साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी फॉर नेशनल डेवलपमेंट फॉर दिस ईयर सेशन डिस्टिंग्विश्ड डेलीगेट्स द नेशन विल ऑलवेज बी ग्रेटफुल टू द साइंटिस्ट हू हैव वर्कड टायरलेसली टू एम्पावर अवर सोसाइटी बाय देयर विजन लेबर and leadership. In November 2016, the country lost one such eminent scientist and institutional builder, Dr. M.G.K. Menon. I join you in paying tribute to him. Distinguished delegates, the speed and scale of changes we encounter today are unprecedented. How are we going to respond to these changes and challenges that we do not even know could arise? It is a deep-rooted curiosity, scientific tradition, which allows quick adaptation to new realities. Tomorrow's experts will come from investments we make today in our people and infrastructure. My government is committed to supporting different streams of scientific knowledge, ranging from fundamental science to applied science, with emphasis on innovations. Distinguished delegates, in the last two sessions of the Science Congress, I presented before you several key challenges and opportunities for the nation. Some of these important challenges are in the key sector of clean water and energy, food, environment, climate security, and healthcare. We equally need to keep an eye on the rise of disruptive technologies and be prepared to leverage them for growth. We need to clearly assess the challenges and opportunities for our technology readiness and competitiveness. I have been told that the technology vision 2035 document released in last year's Science Congress is now developing into a detailed roadmap for 12 key technology sectors. Further, Niti Aayog is evolving a holistic science and technology vision for the country. One important area that needs to be addressed is the rapid global rise of cyber physical systems. This has the potential to pose unprecedented challenges and stresses to our demographic dividend. But we can trust into a huge opportunity by research, training, and skilling in robotics, artificial intelligence, digital manufacturing, big data analysis, deep learning, quantum communication, and Internet of Things. There is a need to develop and exploit these technologies in services and in manufacturing sectors, in agriculture, water, energy, traffic management, health environment, infrastructure, and geo-information systems, security, financial systems, and in combating crime. We need to develop an inter-ministerial national mission in the cyber physical systems to secure our future by creation of basic R&D infrastructure, manpower, and skills. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the oceans that surround the Indian Peninsula have over 1,300 of our islands. They also give us a 7,500 kilometer coastline and 2.4 million square kilometers of exclusive economic zone. They contain enormous opportunities in energy, food, medicine, and a host of other natural resources. The ocean economy could be a significant dimension of our sustainable future. I am told that the Ministry of Earth Sciences is working to launch a deep ocean mission to explore, understand, and harness these resources in a responsible way. This could be a transformative step for the prosperity and security of the nation. Distinguished delegates, our best science and technology institutions should further strengthen their basic research in line with leading global standards. Translating this basic knowledge into innovations, startups, and industry will help us achieve inclusive and sustainable growth. Scopus database indicates that India now ranks 6th in the world with respect to scientific publications, growing at a rate of about 14% as against the world average growth rate of about 4%. I'm sure that our scientists will further meet the challenges of enhanced quality of basic research, its technology translation, and its connect with society. By 2030, India will be among the top 3 countries in science and technology and will be among the most attractive destinations for the best talent in the world. The wheels we set in motion today will achieve this goal. Distinguished delegates, science must meet the rising aspirations of our people. India fully appreciates the strong role science and technology plays in meeting the societal needs. We must address the problems of urban-rural divide and work for inclusive development, economic growth, and employment generation. To enable this, there is a need for a new overarching structure that will coordinate with all the relevant stakeholders. Our ability to mount and execute large national missions requires effective partnership that integrate with a large stakeholders base. The effectiveness of these missions can be ensured only by getting out of our deep-rooted silos and adopting a collaborative approach, which is essential to address our multifarious development challenges rapidly and effectively. Our ministries, our scientists, R&D institutions, industries, startups, universities, and IITs all should work together seamlessly. In particular, our infrastructure and socio-economic ministries must make appropriate use of science and technology. Our institution could consider inviting outstanding scientists from abroad, including NRIs, for long-term research associations. We should involve foreign and NRI PhD students in postdoctoral research in our projects. Another empowering factor for scientific delivery is the ease of doing science. If we want science to deliver, we must not constrain building a strong science and technology infrastructure that is accessible to academia, startups, industry, and R&D labs is a priority for the government. We need to address the problems of ease of access, maintenance, redundancy, and duplication of expensive equipment in our scientific institutions. The need of establishing professionally managed large regional centers in PPP model, housing high-value scientific equipment, should be examined. On the lines of corporate social responsibility, the concept of scientific social responsibility introduced to connect our leading institutions to all stakeholders, including schools and colleges. We must create an environment for sharing of ideas and resources. The brightest and best in every corner of India should have the opportunity to excel in science. This will ensure that our youth get high-end training exposure to the best of science and technology to make them job ready in a competitive world. To this end, I would exhort the national laboratories to connect with schools and colleges to develop appropriate training programs. This will also help with the effective use and maintenance of our vast scientific and technological infrastructure. Laboratories, research institutions and universities in each major city region should be interlinked to function on a hub and spoke model. The hubs will share major infrastructure, drive our national science missions, and be the engines that link discovery to applications. College teachers with background in research can be connected to the neighboring universities and R&D institutions. Outreach activities from the institutions of eminence to schools, colleges and polytechnics will activate the latent science and technology manpower from the educational institutions in your neighborhoods. Distinguished delegates, seeding the power of ideas and innovation in school children will broaden the base of our innovation pyramid and secure the future of our nation. As a step in this direction, Ministry of Science and Technology is initiating a program focused on students of classes 6 to 10. The program will scout, mentor, reward, and showcase 10 lakh top innovative ideas focused on local needs from 5 lakh schools. We must provide equal opportunities to the girl child to enroll and excel in the underrepresented disciplines of science and engineering and ensure continued participation of trained women scientists in nation building. Distinguished delegates, for a large and diverse country like India, technology needs to span a wide range from advanced space, nuclear and defense technologies to rural development needs in providing clean water, sanitation, renewable energy, community health, etc. While we excel globally, we also need to develop local solutions that fit our unique context. There is a need to develop appropriate micro-industry models for the rural areas that use local resources and skills to meet the local needs and generate local enterprise and employment. For example, we should develop a host of technologies based on efficient co-generation for clusters of villages and semi-urban areas. This technology should aim to convert agri and bio-waste to satisfy multiple needs of electricity, clean water, crop processing, and cold storage. Distinguished delegates, the role of science in planning, decision-making, and governance has never been more important. We need to develop and deploy geo-information systems to meet the development goals of our citizens, gram panchayat, districts and states. A coordinated efforts by the Survey of India, ISRO and the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology can be a transformative. For sustainable development, we must take strong measures to focus on waste-to-wealth management in the critical areas of electronic waste, biomedical and plastic waste, and solid waste and wastewater solutions. We are scaling up R&D on clean carbon technologies for enhancement of energy efficiency and increase and efficient use of renewable energy. Focus on environment and climate remains our priority to ensure sustainable development. Our strong scientific community can also effectively address our unique challenges. For example, can we find farmer-centric solutions to the problem of crop burning? Can we redesign our big kilns for reduced emissions and greater energy efficiency? Science and technology is a key factor in the Startup India program launched in January 2016. Two other strong initiatives are Atal Innovation Mission and NIDHI, the National Initiative for Development and Harnessing Innovations. This program focusing building an innovation-driven enterprise ecosystem. Further, public-private partnerships with CII, FICCI, and high-technology private companies are being pursued to strengthen the innovation ecosystem. Distinguished delegates, our scientists have contributed strongly to the strategic vision of the nation. The Indian Space Program has put India among the top space-faring nations. We have achieved a high degree of self-sufficiency in space technology, including launch vehicle development, payload, and satellite building applications for development and the building of core competence and capacity. The Defense Research and Development Organization has played the role of a force multiplier for the armed forces with its systematic and technologies. We are leveraging strategic international partnership and collaborations based on the principles of mutuality, parity, and reciprocity to make Indian science globally competitive. We are also placing special emphasis on building strong relationship with our neighboring countries and multilateral for such based of global science is helping us unravel creations, mysteries, and develop cutting-edge technologies. Last year, we activated the 3.6-meter optical telescope in Devasthal in Uttarakhand, made with Indo-Belgian collaboration. Recently, we approved the LIGO project with USA to construct a state-of-the-art detector system in India. Distinguished delegates, in conclusion, I wish to reiterate that the government remains committed to provide the best support to our scientists and scientific institutions. I'm sure that our scientists will scale up their efforts ranging from the quality of basic science to technology development to innovation. Let science and technology become a strong tool of inclusive development and betterment of the weakest and poorest segments of our society. Together, we will prevail to make a just, equitable and prosperous nation. Jai Hind. Thank you.